Good morning, church. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. The word of God says, enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. Why? Because the Lord is good. His mercies are everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations. Let's give him a hand of praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Welcome to the Mount of Peace, the place where the presence of the Lord dwells. And this day we are here to give him thanks and praise, to exalt his name, for he is indeed a good God. He is indeed a good God. I invite the church to stand as we honor him with a clap of praise this morning. And if you are watching in your living rooms, in your bedrooms, in your car, just give him a hand of praise and appreciation, because the Lord that we serve is a good God. And today we are here to celebrate. We are here to worship him. We are here to honor him and to give him praise and adoration.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our God is a good God. Our God is a mighty God. And today the church in Mount Salem gathers to worship and to praise. Oh God, we give you this time. We give you our place, Lord, to honor you, Lord. Take full control, Lord, of this service, Lord. It belongs to you, oh God, for your glory and honor. Oh God, let there be deliverance in this house today. Lives are going to be changed. Oh God, deeds are going to be met. And Lord, you are going to be glorified. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We invite you to come and to lead in worship the praise team. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's honor him today as the praise team comes to worship him. Hallelujah.
Yeah, just keep the praise going. Just keep the praises going. There is much to be thankful for. There is a lot to be thankful for. Hallelujah. God is good. God is good. God is good. There is no God like Jehovah. Hallelujah. He's holy. He's righteous. He's faithful. And he took on brokenness for you and for me. What a wonderful God we serve. Give him the highest praise this morning, for he is worthy. Worthy are you, O Lord. Father, worthy are you. There is just none to be compared unto you, O God. None, O God. Because none could have done what you did for us. Hallelujah. And so we just magnify you this morning, God. Regardless of the situation or the circumstances, God, you are worthy of worship. You are worthy of praise. You are worthy to be adored. Hallelujah. So we sing, holiness, holiness is what I long for. Holiness is what I need. Holiness, holiness is what you want from me. Can we sing that again? Everybody sing, holiness, holiness is what I long for. Holiness is what I need. Holiness, holiness, beginning, oh God. You are the end. You are also everything in between. Hallelujah. There is just none to be compared to our God. None to be compared to Him. If you believe it, give Him a clap offering this morning. For He's worthy, 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 worthy. Hallelujah. 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 You reign forevermore. And so we give Him every praise this morning. Hallelujah. Every praise is due unto Him. Every hallelujah is due unto Him. Every I love you is due unto Him. Every thank you is due unto Him. Hallelujah. Every praise is to our God. Hallelujah. He's alive. He's well. And He tells us that He inhabits our praises. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you feel like dancing, dance, because He loves it. So we're going to lift our voices. Hallelujah. Every praise is to our God. Every word of worship with one accord. Every praise is to our God, and every
Every praise is toward our God. Glory, hallelujah. If there is no praise, then we won't be having any form of glory to God, any at all. Good morning. Mine is the pleasure to be your moderator today. My name is Lorraine Warren. And as we go through these proceedings, we will continue to ask God to be with us. At this time, we will ask Sister Sharon Clark to come with the morning scripture. And it is taken from Exodus 12, verses 30 to 42.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Good morning, brothers and sisters.
Good morning.
That's better. Our lesson is taken this morning from Exodus 12, from 30 to 42. Could you stand where I read? In the night, and all his servants, and all the Egyptians, and there was a great cry in Egypt, for there was a house where there was not one bed. And he called for Moses and Aaron by night, and said, Rise up, and get you forth from among my people, both ye and the children of Israel, and go, serve the Lord as ye have said. Also, take your flocks, and your herds, and ye have said, and be gone, and bless me also. And the Egyptians were urgent upon the people, that they might send them out of the land in haste, for they said, We'll be all dead men. And the people took their dough, for it was laden, their kneading troughs, being bound up in their clothes upon their shoulders. And the children of Israel did according to the word of Moses, and they borrowed of the Egyptians jewels of silver and jewels of gold and raiment. And the Lord gave the people favor in the sight of the Egyptians, so that they lent unto them such things as they required, and they spoiled the Egyptians. And the children of Israel journeyed from Ramesh to Succoth, about 600,000 on foot, that were men beside children. And a mixed multitude went up also with them, and the flocks and herds, even very much cattle. And they baked unleavened cakes of dough, which they brought forth out of Egypt, for it was not leavened, because they were tossed out of Egypt, and could not tarry, neither had they prepared for themselves any victual. Now the sojourning of the children of Israel, who dwelt in Egypt, was 430 years. And it came to pass, at the end of the 430 years, even the selfsame day, it came to pass that all the hosts of the Lord went out from the land of Egypt. 42, alas. It is a night to be much observed unto the Lord for bringing them out from the land of Egypt. This is that night of the Lord to be observed of all the children of Israel in their generation. And this is the word of the Lord. We honor it by saying,
Thanks be to God.
Good morning again. Is there anything that you need to be thankful for today? Is there anything at all that you need to be thankful for today? Give the Lord a resounding round of applause for his goodness. I say that because we are here today, and we don't know what our next minute, what our next hour, or what our next day will bring. And I say this because earlier this week, or Monday, I went to work and got a sad news. The Friday before that, I learned that a friend of ours was very ill and was about to go into surgery. It was news to me at the time. However, persons had known that she was ailing for a while. So I said, okay, I will give her that particular call. On Saturday, I made the call. However, I did not get through. And I said, okay, I'll try again. I did not try again because I knew she was going into surgery. So I said, I will at least wait until the recovery, because I thought that because I wasn't getting through, she was already in surgery. On Monday when I got to work, I got the sad news. She had passed. So whatever it is that you have to say to a loved one today, whatever it is, it doesn't have to be a loved one. It may be someone that you received a word for. Give it to them. Don't keep it. Don't hide it in your hearts. Give it to them because they need that word. They need to know that the love of God resounds in them. And they need to know that God is their comforter and God is their strength. So I ask, as we go into our session of intercessory, that you think about that incident that you think that you cannot give anybody any forgiveness for. You think about that person that you have not seen for a very long time that you need to call up and just say hi and give an encouraging word. You need to think about your neighbor who you have not spoken to in a couple of months. It's your neighbor. In a couple of years, it's your neighbor. Go and remind them that you are still alive. Inquire of them how they are. And then, if you can, you give a word of encouragement. You don't have to tarry long. You just have to give them that word and move on. So, at this time, we will ask Brother Martin, the elder one, to come and do the intercessory prayer.
Today we serve a God who is ever present. We serve a God who is always there listening to us. We serve a God who is sovereign. And today as we come into this house, we want to give him thanks for just who he is and for what he has done for us. I want to pray for somebody today. You may be challenged by a very difficult situation, whatever it is, whether it's related to illness or it's a special need. I want to pray for you today. If you're in church, I'm going to invite you to exercise your faith and stand so we pray for you. If you're watching at home, wherever you are, just exercise that faith that I believe that God will do for me what he promised in his word. It is in believing that we receive that which God has promised us. So if there's anything in your life that you want us to intercede with you today, ask God to do it for you. So by faith, exercise that faith today. Exercise that faith today and stand. And place that issue before God, who sees ahead of time, who knows exactly what it is that you need and what he'll do for you. Hallelujah. We want to give God thanks for the fact that our sister Beverly Mother is now home, released from the hospital. We want to thank God that his work continues even our lives. As we remember those who are sick among us, we want to remember our sister Mackenzie, who is going into surgery tomorrow in the hospital. We want to pray for our sister Ramsing's mother, who isn't that well. We want to believe God is there. And today we want to approach God because He is. He is our God. By faith. Exercise that faith today. Hallelujah. Lord, we believe in You. Lord, Your word is ever sure. Father, You stand behind Your word. And God, You said in Your word, if we call on You, You will answer us. It is Your word, O God, which says You will hear the prayer of the righteous. And God, we are among the righteous because we are the righteous today. Father, it is Your word also, which says to us, You will hear every prayer that's offered in this house. Hallelujah. And we believe that, oh God, today. And we trust in Your word, Lord. So God, as Your people stand before You, Lord, with varying needs and concerns, oh Lord, and issues, oh God, we pray for them, Lord. Minister, oh God, to them today. Stretch forth Your hand, oh God, and touch Your people, oh God, in this house. And God, for those who are at home and those who are watching everywhere in the world, Lord, I pray, God, You will touch them, oh God, in their living rooms, in their bedrooms, in their cars, wherever they are, God. Because You are, there's no distance in prayer. You are omnipresent, Lord. You are everywhere, oh God. Heal Your people, oh God, today. Deliver Your people, oh God, today. Comfort, oh God. Comfort Your people, oh God, today with Your word. But not only with Your word, but with your presence, God. Because You promised that You'll never leave us. You'll never forsake us. You will be with us in good times. You promised to be with us, oh God, in bad times. You promised, oh God, to be with us, Lord, in those times when we are lonely. Oh God, we say, show up for Your people today, Lord. Show up for Your people today. Heal, set free, deliver, God, in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray right now for our pastor, Reverend Balfour. Lord, who wasn't dwelling the week earlier, Lord, but God, You touched him. And God, as he's coming with Your word, I pray for physical strength. I pray for spiritual strength. I pray, oh God, for that special anointing, oh God, that he'll be strong to deliver Your word. And God, as we who are hearers today in this house, You would have healed, oh God. You would have strengthened, oh God. You would have restored, oh God. And so God, we who are here in this house will take time, God, to give You the honor, the glory, and the praise. Thank You, Lord, for what You have done and for what You continue to do, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. And the body of Christ agree with an amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Good morning again. We here at Mount Salem love to have persons visiting with us, and we also like when we have persons in the house who are able to worship, and also you in radio and TV land, we would also love to welcome you. So the person who does that best is our pastor, Gary Balfour. He'll be coming to give the welcome.
When I think of the goodness of Jesus and what He has done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah, thank God. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and what He has done for me, to your neighbor and say, neighbor, wake up. Amen. Come on, clap those hands and worship the Lord. Amen. God is a good God. The Bible tells us that God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Amen. And it's a glorious opportunity that God has afforded us to be in his presence to worship him. Just stand right where you are and just lift up your voices and just clap those hands like you really want to tell the Lord, I'm thankful for my salvation. Come on. Hallelujah. I could have been down and out. I could have been somewhere else. But he's all over me. And he's keeping me alive. Oh, somebody praise him in the house. Hallelujah. I feel Jesus in this place. You may be seated. I greet you, our moderator, and you wonderful saints, in the wonderful, the powerful, and the all-sufficient name of our God and his Christ. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we are here rejoicing, and we are glad in it. Amen? Because indeed the Lord is worthy to be praised. I want to use this opportunity to welcome all of us, those that are here and those that are watching online. Do we have anybody visiting us for the first time? Yes, no, maybe so. All right. Well, to one and all, a very warm welcome. Look across to your neighbor, whether to your left or to your right, and say, hey, neighbor. Amen. You are looking so nice. Yes, 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 yes. Yes. You must respond and tell him, say, you look nice too, you know? All right. But for those we haven't seen for a while, we want to extend welcome to you. We want to also recognize the presence of Dr. Blake. Always a pleasure having you, and the Lord richly bless you. Welcome. And we wish for you God's richest blessings. And I know Chantal and the baby, they are somewhere wrong. We want to extend special welcome to them. Please put your hands together and bless them. Welcome, welcome. We are so happy to have you. We are so happy to have Auntie Pansy and Auntie Andrea in the house. Oh, yes, Auntie Andrea is still under quarantine. We hope she's watching. But yes, bless you, Auntie Andrea, and bless you, Auntie Pansy. Always a pleasure. You know, these guys, we really love them at Mount Salem because over the years they have been good to us, especially their contribution to our VBS. And we want to also recognize Auntie Andrea and her church, the Worship Center, right? We are happy for you guys. And we say big up to you and your pastor and the entire church family. Yeah. We're happy. Listen, the Worship Center is a part of Mount Salem Open Bible. Yeah. And Mount Salem Open Bible is a part of the Worship Center. All right? Yeah. And so we are really happy to have them. And that's in Florida, right, Auntie Patsy? Orlando, Florida, yes. And so we are happy. So please, Auntie Andrea, greet your bishop for us. And tell him how much we love him and the congregation, and we are grateful always for their love and the support. Amen. And so we continue to give God glory, and we continue to give him praise. All right? Just before I take my seat, I just want to tender the apology on behalf of Sister Ramsing. She is not here due to circumstances beyond her control. All right? But let us continue to pray for her and for her family. Sister Debbie, our secretary, she's not here. Let us continue to remember her in our prayers. Amen? I wish for you God's richest blessings and a wonderful rest of the day. May you continue to be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. All right? God bless you.
Okay. Are you ready for the word? Are you ready for the word?
Yes.
Yes. And remember as believers, if you are hungry, the Lord will be able to feed you. Right? So you must go and hunger for the word. And if you're thirsty, through your faith, your thirst will be quenched. So we will be receiving that word. However, before we get any food from our shepherd, that is Reverend Balfour, we are going to ask representatives of the Men of Vision to come and bless our hearts at this time. And then the next voice you hear will be our pastor.
Hallelujah. Our God is good. Amen.
Amen.
It's good that we serve a God who is our anchor. And we sing that the anchor holds and it grips the solid rock. And we have an anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure while the billows roll. Hallelujah. Is he your anchor? Is he your anchor? Hallelujah. I have journeyed through the long dark nights out on the open. Watching me, the anchor holds, though the ship is battered, the anchor holds, though the sails are torn.
it came to pass that all the hosts of the Lord went out from the land of Egypt. I'll go down to about 42. It is a night to be much observed unto the Lord for bringing them out from the land of Egypt. This is that night of the Lord to be observed of all the children of Israel in their generation. Again, it is a night to be much observed unto the Lord for bringing them out from the land of Egypt. This is that night of the Lord to be observed of all the children of Israel in their generations. And the church say, amen. Tell me about your coming out. Oh God, I feel my health here. It doesn't matter how long you have been in the situation. I have news for the enemy this morning, Elder Martin. Time come. Hello, somebody. Anything that you are going through, God is going to take you out of it. Your midnight deliverance is coming. I want to address somebody on the line this morning to say, whatever you are going through, it is not forever. Your midnight deliverance is coming. God, somebody help me in the house this morning. Clap those hands and worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Bow your heads with me. Father, we acknowledge your presence because indeed you are God and there is absolutely no God like you. Glorious you are in holiness and fearful in praises, doing wonders. We ask this morning, Lord, that you will manifest your glory, you will manifest your power in this house, and that God will speak with power, clarity, and precision. And you'll cause that your Holy Spirit, oh God, will move in an awesome way in this house. That as we give you the glory, the honor, and the praise, your name, oh God, will be exalted. And all God's people say, amen. Amen. Your midnight deliverance is coming. I want to ask, are you trapped in a deadbeat job, a deadbeat relationship, a business? Are you trapped in an unbearable emotional rut? If the answer is yes, then certainly you'd agree with me that being in such a position is not a comfortable position. Are you here with me? And depending on what the situation is, you might feel as though you are suffocating, because sometimes we find ourselves in some situations and it seems as if it is sucking the very breath out of your body. Somebody say, sound like me. And you are saying, Pastor, by whatever means, I want to get out of this situation. If that is your situation this morning, I am here to tell you that your time of deliverance is coming. Hello, somebody. Everything that we go through, it is only for a time. Somebody praise God. I want to somehow bring to attention the fact that God's chosen people, the children of Israel, and you know when you are chosen, not who you are special. Are you chosen? Yes. And you feel special. And you don't want to feel as though you are treated in any kind of way bad. You want to know that you are well taken care of. And so somebody might ask, Jillian, how is it that God's chosen people would have been in bondage for some 430 years? Generations on top of generations. It would
appear as though God has forgotten them. And might be somebody this morning, you are going through your situation. You know, sometimes when we go through, and you feel as if God has forgotten you. But I want to encourage somebody today that as night follows day, it doesn't matter how long you are in the situation. I want to sound the trumpet this morning and declare time come.
I sound like I'm in the wrong church this morning, but I feel a little preachified. Because, you know, like the children of Israel, sometimes we have gone through with things and we have said, God, when are you going to deliver me? But I just want to say up front to somebody that weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. I want to say to all my young people and those my age and those little above and those little below, it doesn't matter what you are going through. There's coming a time for your deliverance. Your midnight is coming and every fear will have to give way, because when God gets ready, somebody help me here, them could have been bullfolk or don't be conqueror. Deliverance is coming. Because weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. Somebody say, help me, Jesus. So for 430 years, God's children were held in captivity in Egyptian bondage. But my brothers and sisters, it is important for us to understand the history behind it. Brother Vidal, what did I say? It's important for us to understand the history. Tell your neighbor, say, anything you have got through, get the history behind it. Yes. I feel I'm going to preach in this house. Tell somebody else, whatever you are going through, there is a history behind it. Tell your neighbor, it's important to get the history. It is important to get the history. So let me present a little background here. So in Genesis 15, 13, and 14, and Shamar, please get it up there for me. Let us understand the background. Genesis 15, 13, and 14, God spoke to Abram. He was not yet Abraham. Abram. And said to him, know certainly, somebody says certainly, that your descendants will be strangers in a land that is not theirs. Tell your neighbor, get the history. Mm-hmm. And will serve them, and they will afflict you, and they will afflict them for the 430 years. Amen. So I wanted to understand that. So let's get it. Right there. And he said unto Abram, know of a surety, somebody said surety, that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs. Somebody said, down in Egypt. And shall serve them, and they shall afflict them 400 years. Now, you see this 400 years here, but in Exodus you see 430. Another time I'll tell you about that. Continue. And also, that nation whom they shall serve will I judge. And afterward, they shall come out with great substance. Tell your neighbor, you're not coming out empty. You're not coming out empty. You're not coming out empty. So let us understand the background behind all of this. From way back in Genesis, God said, listen to me, Abraham. Your descendants, somebody said descendants, will find themselves in a land that is not theirs. And they will be afflicted. But guess what? I am going to visit you, and I'm going to deliver you. But not only that, when you are coming out, you are not coming out empty-handed. Hello, somebody. Tell your neighbor, I'm coming out better. I'm coming out better. Hallelujah. And so it is important to understand the history. Somebody help me here. But just to refresh your memory a little bit, Joseph went down to Egypt
because his jealous brother sold him into slavery. Somebody say, get the history. And he rose to become the second most powerful person in Pharaoh's kingdom, Joseph. And you remember the story. And while he was there, God would have given him divine wisdom to put things in place, because there was coming a famine. Somebody say famine. And upon that moment, Jacob and his family moved to Egypt during the famine. For the most part, my brothers and sisters, they enjoyed a relatively good life. And many theologians believed that for about 215 years, everything was nice. Somebody say nice. But tell your neighbor, Pharaoh is a very bad Pharaoh. And so, Jacob and his family moved to Egypt during the famine. And as I said, for the most part, things would have been relatively good. But my brothers and sisters, the king realized that they were increasing in numbers. They were getting bigger and mightier. Tell your neighbor, get the history. I want Shamar to give me Exodus chapter 1. Verses 6 to 13. And I'm taking my time here because we are going to preach in this house. So remember, God said to Abraham, your descendants, they are going to go into a land that is not theirs. They are going to be afflicted. But when they are coming out, they will not come out empty. And then you realize, because Joseph's jealous brothers sold him into slavery, and he ended up there in Egypt. And God would have used him to prepare the way. And then Jacob carried his family down into Egypt. And things for a while would have been good. But watch this. Are we there? And Joseph died. Somebody said died. And all his brethren. And all that generation. And the children of Israel were fruitful. Somebody said fruitful. In other words, they were having a lot of children. Just like how they say in the COVID time. Alright, I'm going to behave myself. So behave yourself, pastor. Yeah. So watch this. They were down there in bondage. And they were getting fruitful. They were multiplying. Tell your neighbor, get the history. And the children of Israel were fruitful. And increased abundantly. And multiplied. And waxed exceedingly mighty. Somebody say mighty. And the land was filled with them. Mm-hmm. Now there arose up a new king, a new Pharaoh over Egypt, which did not know Joseph. Can I read that again? Now there arose up a new king over Egypt, a new Pharaoh, which knew not Joseph. I want to pause here, Sister Clark, to say to the body of Christ, be careful of the Pharaoh when I know you. Jesus. You know, you can be in an organization and you'd have given years upon years, and all of a sudden, there's a new manager. Oh God, I want to preach, you know. I want to hear myself. All of a sudden, there's a new supervisor. Who don't know the work where you put in. And jealousy start to come. Can I tell somebody, be careful of the fear when you know you tell your neighbor, get the history. I'm going to preach a little here. And he said unto his people, behold, the people of the children of Israel are more and mightier than we. Continue. Come on. Let us deal wisely with them, lest they multiply. And it came to pass that when there falleth out any war, they join also unto our enemies and fight against us. So get them up out of the land. Somebody say, get the history. Continue right up to 13. Tell your neighbor, sit down good. And the Egyptians made the children of Israel to serve them with rigor. What God said to Abraham was this was the fulfillment. That listen to me, you are going to go into a land that is not yours. They are going to treat you a particular way. But understand this, I am going to take you up. So remember now, I said to you that for about 215 years, they were going on quite good. Then arose a Pharaoh, somebody said Pharaoh, who did not know Joseph. The good work Joseph did in the kingdom. And jealousy was now in his heart. Listen to me, a long time jealousy ago, you know. You know that some people will hate you for no reason at all. Oh God Almighty, can I just talk it the way I feel it this morning? I'm laying a foundation because I feel a little bit preachy. People will be jealous over you for no reason at all. Not you young people.
Yes.
Not you young people.
Yes.
You don't have to do nobody nothing and them just jealous over you. You know? Because them see things have gone for you. You dress good, you walk good, you talk good, you smell good and everything good. Somebody help me here. They will just rise up against you. Be careful of the fear of who? Hallelujah, somebody. And so when Pharaoh looked at the children of Israel, he said, no man, they are multiplying. And jealousy was now in his heart. And he said, Julian, listen here. If we allow them to continue like this, if there's a war over some, they will join with the enemy and they will overthrow us. Tell you, they forget the history. Because sometimes we are going through some stuff. And if you don't understand the history behind it, you will find yourself in trouble. And so Fear said, listen to me, we have to heap on the pressure on them. Because if they continue like this, we are going to be in trouble. But old time people have a saying. Them say, man a plan. Yeah, Jesus, preach with me, man. Them say, man a plan, but God a wipe up. You see, Pharaoh didn't understand that this is a part of God's will. You can heap on the pressure all you want. I am built to last. Oh God Almighty, can I talk to the church this morning? Tell the neighbor, bring it on. I am built to last. I am built from good material because I am a child of the living God. Somebody give him praise and glory in the house. Hallelujah. And so jealousy was now in his heart, Dora. And he said, listen to me. We can't allow them to continue like this. We have to put pressure on them. So around the 215th year, this particular Pharaoh said, listen to me. We can't allow them to multiply. Because if we allow that, we will be in trouble. Can I tell you something, my brothers and sisters? Let me take off the glasses so you can hear me. Anytime you are growing in the Lord, anytime you are prospering, the devil is going to call conference.
Yes.
Somebody help me here. Can I preach, lady Anderson? Anytime things are going well for you, mark your bottom dollar. Your Pharaoh is going to call a conference. Oh God, somebody help me this morning. But let Pharaoh call all the conference. He wants to call. I will be like a lion in Zion. Because who God bless, no man curse. Somebody talk to me here. I am a child of God. Put on the pressure all you want. My deliverance is coming. Tell your neighbor, get the history. Because knowledge is key. Knowledge is powerful. So, that is how they were enslaved. Because of jealousy. Pharaoh said, listen to me. We can't continue like that. They are free and they are going on. We are going to put them in slavery. We are going to put them in bondage, telling them that the devil is a liar. So that was how they became enslaved, thus fulfilling what God said to Abraham in Genesis 15, 13 and 14. That they'll be strangers in a land that is not theirs and be afflicted. But in the end, they will be delivered. You see, my brothers and sisters, it is important to know how you get into the situation. History is important. Chances are, if you don't know how you get you get into that situation, you'll not understand how you're going to come out. But my brothers and sisters, I want to submit to you that if God is for you, then who can be against you? It doesn't matter the fear that is in and around you at that time. If God is on your side, then victory is assured. I might be going through my test now, but I am going to be delivered in the future. Somebody give him praise and glory in the house of God. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, deliverance is coming. Deliverance is coming. God, I feel I'm going to preach in this house. Somebody shout glory. I want to leave some things with you. Number one, while we deal with the fear of this morning, number one, God will pressure your enemy to the breaking point. What did I say? God will pressure your enemy to the breaking point. The manifestation, my brothers and sisters, of the 10th plague, the death of the firstborn of human and cattle, was the breaking point for the deliverance of the children of Israel from Pharaoh's grip and from Pharaoh's bondage. You see, my brothers and sisters, at the night when the death angel was going through from Pharaoh's palace down to the dungeon, every firstborn was struck and they died. You see, my brothers and sisters, I want to submit to you this morning that it doesn't matter what the enemy is putting you through, God will pressure your enemy to the breaking point. Somebody say, pressure the enemy, Lord. Come on, tell your neighbor, pressure the enemy, Lord. Watch this. Verses 29 through to 31. And it came to pass, somebody say, came to pass, that at midnight, somebody said midnight. You know, some important things seem to happen at midnight. Hello, somebody. Hallelujah. And it came to pass that at midnight, somebody said midnight, that the Lord smote all the firstborn in the land of Egypt. Somebody said, That night, at midnight, the Lord smote all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, from the firstborn of Pharaoh. Somebody say a quote. From the firstborn of Pharaoh that sat on his throne, unto the firstborn of the captive that was in the dungeon. Somebody say, And all the firstborn cattle. And Pharaoh rose up in the night, he and all his servants and all the Egyptians. And there was a great cry in Egypt, telling me about time come. For there was not a host there that was not one dead. Verse 31. And he called for Moses and Aaron by night. Somebody said, put on the pressure, Lord. And he called for Moses and Aaron by night and said, rise up and get you forth from among my people, both ye and the children of Israel, and go serve the Lord as he have said. But hold on. Not the same Pharaoh who said earlier, Sister Dove, I will not let you go. Not the same Pharaoh. But understand this. God will pressure the enemy to breaking point. And so I want to tell somebody this morning that it doesn't matter what you are going through, God is on the job and God will pressure your fear to the breaking point. I don't hear anybody here this morning. Hallelujah. He who said, I will not let you go. My God, when pressure came, Can I preach it? Can I preach it? When pressure start reach Pharaoh, at midnight Pharaoh said, me can't take it any longer. Oh, God Almighty, good God Almighty, I want somebody to understand this morning, and I'll continue to repeat it. Whatever you are going through, God will pressure your enemy to the breaking point, because weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. He who said, I will not let you go, when God pressure him at midnight, he called for Moses and Aaron, and he said, it's time for you to go. Somebody talk to me in the house. Somebody talk to me in the house. I want to tell somebody, time come. So, it took the 10th plague. The 10th plague. And that was when they got their deliverance. The 10th plague. The death of the firstborn. Brothers and sisters, I want you to understand this. That 10, somebody said 10. It's a very important number to God. What did I say? 10 is a very important number to God. The 10th plague was the breaking point. Somebody said, put on the pressure, Lord. Mm-hmm. So 10 is very important to God. Know this. It can mean God's order of completion or judgment. What did I say? It can mean God's order of completion or
judgment.
Human beings. I just run through a few of them. A whole lot. I run through a few of them. The importance of 10. Human beings. We have 10 fingers and 10 toes. Somebody say completion. Divine completion. Pharaoh came in at the 10th plague. Completeness of judgment. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? God will put on the pressure at the 10th plague. That was the breaking point, the completion of judgment. Somebody said, put on the pressure, Lord. Not only that, the term God said appears 10 times in Genesis creation week. Completeness of creation. Somebody said, the power of 10. Passover lamb was to be sacrificed on the 10th day of the first month. Somebody said, the power of 10. There were exactly 10 generations that lived before or up to the time of Noah's flood. Somebody said, the power of 10. There were 10 virgins. Somebody said, the power of 10. And so, at the 10th plague, Dr. Martley, it was the breaking point. Pharaoh could not take the pressure any longer. Good God Almighty, I want to say to the Lord, on behalf of somebody today, put on the pressure, Lord. Pressure the enemy, because I must get my victory in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout something here. Somebody shout something here. Hallelujah. And so plague number one. Pharaoh's heart was hardened. And Pharaoh said, I will not let you go. Plague number two. Pharaoh's heart was hardened. Grace and Pharaoh said, I will not let you go. Plague number three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Pharaoh's heart was hardened. And he said, I will not let you go. Plague nine, his heart was still hardened, and he said, I will not let you go. But tell your neighbor, number 10 is coming. Oh, God Almighty, can I preach here? God is about to call somebody's number 10, and the devil will have to pack up in the name of Jesus. Somebody talk to me here. I say, God, put on the pressure in the mighty name of Jesus. I feel my preacher coming here. Good God Almighty, because the enemy sometimes is acting as though he has all power over you, because you are crying today and it seems as if you are not getting your breakthrough. You cry tomorrow and there's no breakthrough, but every cry, I am one step closer to my miracle. Every cry, I'm one step closer to my breakthrough, because God is upon Come on, young people. Come on, everybody. That devil is a liar. I stand by here to preach to somebody this morning and to tell somebody that if God be for us, then who can be against us? I cannot preach here. I need to tell somebody that as long as God is with you, then you are going to make it. Sometimes you feel forgotten. Sometimes you feel cast down. Sometimes you feel rejected and despised. But God is going to visit you, and your midnight breakthrough is coming like Paul and Silas behind the prison bars. But God Almighty, they worship the Lord and they praise the name of the Lord who is worthy. Talk to me here. There is something about midnight. There's coming a midnight cry. Yes, somebody, in the name of Jesus, put on the pressure, Lord. Put on the pressure on the enemy, because when the enemy's pressured, there will be a deliverance. Somebody clap your hands and give God praise. Woo! You know, young people, one and all, sometimes we go through, you know, and it seems as if you're not getting a deliverance. Somebody says, sound like me? Hello? Anybody? You ever go through something yet? I say, God, when you are going to deliver me? When you are going to come through? But can I tell you a news flash? The same way the devil I watch you, and the same way God I watch you. Oh, Jesus. Can I preach it here? The same way the devil, he's there and he's watching you. Watching your every move and trying to set up blockages, trying to stop you. The Bible said that the eyes of the Lord run it through the earth. Can I talk to somebody? So even when I'm in my bondage, the eyes of the Lord are upon me. Oh, can I preach in the house? Come on here, somebody. Because a long time the devil has messed with you and you feel like you're in chains. Hands are chained. Dead. Your feet seem to be in shackles, but in the name of Jesus, I'm gonna call on the name of Jesus, because God is gonna pressure the enemy to breaking point. Somebody shout something here. Hallelujah! Watch this. Prior to the 10th plague, Moses and Aaron would have to seek audience with Pharaoh. Jesus, somebody help me here. But when God was ready for the complete judgment, the death of the firstborn, God Almighty, Elder Markley, a Pharaoh comes seeking out. Oh, somebody help me here. God not easy, no, my brothers and sisters. God is not easy. Pharaoh had to run to them because he couldn't sleep. Because the real big man, God Almighty, the El Elyon, the El Gibor, on his throne, God Almighty, and from the firstborn in Pharaoh's kingdom to the firstborn in the dungeon and in the cattle, God Almighty, the death plague was at work. God will pressure the enemy to breaking point. Moses and Aaron didn't have to visit him. He came searching for them, telling them, pack up and move out of here. You see, my brothers and sisters, when God is for you, nobody can be against you. When God is for you, even your enemies will be at peace with you. Somebody shout something here. Ah, somebody talk to me here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That is the God that we serve. You know, God is not in any competition with anybody. Can I say that again? God is not in any competition with anybody. Because we have read the book, and we know that if God is in a battle, you know who the winner is. When Mike Tyson was in his heyday, the gamblers used to make money. Because they know, say, once Tyson in the ring, you're going to be knocked out in the first minute or in the first round.
Amen.
Hello, somebody?
Yes.
Hello, somebody? Yeah. So you know, say, once Tyson is in the ring, you know who is going to win the battle. Can I talk to the church? I want to tell somebody in the house this morning that as long as God is in the battle with you, we know that God will not lose the battle, because he's the undefeated, undisputed champion. Somebody talk to me in the church. God will show your enemy who is the real big man. Somebody shout something here. Somebody say, God of God. Somebody say, put on the pressure, Lord. Pressure the enemy to breaking point. I feel I'm going to preach here. Oh, God Almighty. Oh, God. Lady Ashley Ray, understand this. Can I say to the church that up to the ninth plague, fear was acting as though he was Manayad. And with some kind of bridge, Pharaoh was acting like a him a man of yard.
Yes.
You know, someone got chopped off and said, ah, hey, hey, me and the real big man around there. I'm silent, you know. And so up to the ninth plague, Pharaoh was acting like the real big man. But let me tell you how the real big man operates. When the real big man enter your scene, him not check my face. I feel pretty fine. Yeah. I for some more minutes, man. We just get by number one. That God will pressure your enemy to breaking point. A real big man will come through. Him not ask no permission. But God prepared his people grace. Him say, listen to me. The final judgment is coming. The power of 10. Now where yourself. God say, listen to me. You see, all of you over Goshen, over this up. This is the instruction. You're going to take the animal, kill it, and make sure, oh God, in typology, the symbol of the cross, put it up on the lintel and on the doorpost. It's a symbol of the cross. Just place the blood up on it. Come on, somebody say the blood. Because the real big man will show them what God. I feel preachified. Oh God Almighty. And so God said, listen to me. Just put the blood up on the doorpost. Because tonight, somebody said, tonight, time come. The death angel is going to walk through. And he said, when I see the blood, somebody said, the blood, I will pass over. Can I talk to the church? And so when God get ready, you got to move. You could be rich, you could be poor, you could be black, you could be white, you could be a done it or a done nothing. When God gets ready, you got to move. Put on the pressure, Lord, and pressure the enemy to breaking point. I want to preach in this house. And so, God said, listen to me, and go around if I stretch my imagination long enough. I believe the first house the death angel visited was Pharaoh's. Lord Jesus, help me. Good God Almighty. Pharaoh's firstborn, the man who was acting as if he's a god. Because I want you to understand, the Pharaohs, they were considered gods, and they would sit in temples with other gods, and people would come and worship them. But our God is the real God. Our God is the true and living God. And so Pharaoh was sitting upon his throne. Oh God, in his palace, acting like he is a god, but the real God is still in charge. Good God Almighty. And the death angel went, good God Almighty, and every firstborn from Pharaoh's palace right down. And the Bible said that there was a weeping and a crying, because just when God is in the mix, when Jesus comes, the tempted power is broken. Come on here, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Joshua was mounting up on Pharaoh. Pharaoh said, listen to me. The only way out of this system all, if you get rid of the children of Israel. Tell your neighbor, pressure works. God will pressure the enemy to breaking point. When Pharaoh realized, he said, listen to me, I can't keep them. The tenth plague was the death nail into his coffin. God demonstrated that he is the true God and that he is still in charge. Look here. In the doctrine of God, we understand that God has power over everything. God has power over situations. And God has power over time. Yeah. Hear me, everybody. It doesn't matter what you are going through. You say, Pastor, you don't know how long me I go through this. Help is on the way.
Right.
What did I say? Help is on the way. No storm lasts forever. No. Talk to me here, somebody. So lift up your head and have hope. Because joy is coming in the morning. Can I tell you that God knows best to get the enemy's attention?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
Pharaoh realized that, listen to me, I can't do anything else. Oh, God Almighty. But what he didn't realize, when he was saying to them, pack up and leave, he was fulfilling what God said in jealousy.
Yeah.
Talk to me here. That you're going to be afflicted for a time. But when you are coming out, I will deliver you. And you will come out with more than that which you have entered with. Somebody give God praise and glory in the house. Hallelujah! That's the God that we serve. The tenth plague, my brothers and sisters. The death of the firstborn. God used it to get Pharaoh's attention. Ten is very important to God. It's symbolic either of the completion of judgment or the completion of God's order. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
In Pharaoh's case, the tenth plague was the completeness of God's judgment. Therefore, A, Pharaoh's defense, what did I say? Pharaoh's defense was no match to God's determination. Can I let that settle? Pharaoh's defense was no match to God's determination. God will keep the pressure on the enemy. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Not only that, Pharaoh's detention of Israel was no match to God's deliverance. Pharaoh's detention of Israel was no match to God's deliverance. With a strong hand or with strong hands, God will bring deliverance. Tell your neighbor, deliverance is coming. Thirdly, Pharaoh's desperation was no match to God's demand. God has the final say. If God says you are going to be free, it doesn't matter what the enemy has to say.
Yeah.
Can I talk to somebody this morning?
Yes.
You see, all of them people will trouble you. And worst of all, you don't trouble nobody. Not you with heart.
Yeah,
when people trouble you and they say some things about you, you know, say, you don't trouble nobody. Like one morning, I don't know if I told a story here some time ago, not sure. Was driving, taking Auntie Winsome to work. And traffic, and was trying to come out on the main road. And you know when a heavy traffic in the 7 bells in the morning, and one man decided to let me out. I mean, I push out, right? From the local road to the main road. But you know, say you can't just drive out. So me take time and I push out. And when me look, one man I come full speed and he not stop, you know. And me have to ram the brake. And my boy just drive down and look for me and say, where are you? And he says, so something we can't repeat is, And then he said, but look how you ugly like your car. Lord Jesus. And you know, if me ugly enough, you would have badder no bad because you'd be restating the truth. But don't show me no ugly. Talk the truth, man. If me ugly, you'd have badder no bad Elder Markley. Because all me say, you are telling me something when me know already. Talk to me, man. But me know me no ugly, man. So sometimes, some people trouble you and you not trouble them. And they burn you to your heart. But you have to just leave them to God. I'm still not sure. Uh-oh. Hallelujah. So, amen. Pharaoh's desperation was no match to God's demand. You can try to keep in bondage as long as you want. God say you're going to come out, you're coming out. If God say you're going to be blessed, young people, if God say you're going to excel, because a spirit of excellence is upon you, you are going to make it. It doesn't matter what anybody want to say in the name of Jesus. If God say you are blessed, then you are blessed. If God say you are free, then you are free. If God say you're coming out, then could I be Pharaoh, Bull Buck, or Dummy Conqueror? I'm going to step out in style. Somebody give God praise. Hallelujah! I want to preach in this house. Tell your neighbor, time come. Mm-hmm. Freedom. At midnight, Pharaoh was in trouble. And he ran to them and said, listen, I'm going to free you. It's time for you to go. Oh, God Almighty. You know, my brothers and sisters, when God is doing his stuff, you know, man, God will do it in style.
Yeah, that's true.
You notice that God did not go to Moses and Aaron and say, listen me, it's time to go. No. When pressure was upon Pharaoh, Pharaoh said, listen me, I have to find them money because for them God bad at my God. Yeah. Sorry. The Israelite God is the powerful God because there is no God like our God. He's awesome in power. He's awesome in majesty. Somebody give God praise in the house. Let me hear now. Let me hear now. So we know, number one, that God will pressure the enemy to breaking point. The tenth plague was the final straw. Was a completeness of judgment upon Pharaoh. I want to say to you, my brothers and sisters, because time is going. The enemy's desire is to keep us in all manner of bondage. But God will deliver us. Today, if you are in a mental bondage, a psychological bondage, a spiritual bondage, an emotional bondage, just to name a few, I want you to understand that it is God's desire to deliver you. And in due time, God is going to bring deliverance to you. God is still in the deliverance business. Somebody give him praise and glory.
Hallelujah.
Not only that, God holds the key to our deliverance. I love that.
Yes.
He holds the key to our deliverance. No one else. And I want you to understand that he does need our permission to deliver us. Hallelujah. What did I say? God doesn't need our permission to deliver us. He knows when. One songwriter said, you may not know how, you may not know when, but he'll do it again. Hallelujah. God holds the key to our deliverance. So I say to you, man, woman, boy, and girl, everywhere you are, in the sanctuary, and those listening in cyberspace, God holds the key to our deliverance. No one else. And he doesn't need our permission to deliver. You see, because he's God all by himself. When God fix your enemy, then well fix. Can I say that again? You see, sometimes we are tempted to fix the enemy ourselves. Start the truth. Start the truth, man. All time people say, please God, I shame the devil. But so sometimes you feel like you want to get evil. And you want to fix the enemy for yourself. But I said to you, leave every Pharaoh to God. Because every Pharaoh have their midnight. Hear me, somebody. That midnight is sooner, it's nearer than you think. Because deliverance is coming. Somebody give him praise and glory in the house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Finally, because I know time is going and we're running out of time, but not out of revelation. So number one, I said to you that God will pressure the enemy to breaking point. There's no need for you to pressure the enemy. God will put on the pressure himself. Because some of we are loose with night sleep. And some of we are run up with blood pressure. Talk to me, man. Some of we allow the enemy to put the pressure on and it feel like there's a tightness in your stomach. Talk to me here, somebody. Yeah. Believe them. God knows how to pressure them to breaking point where they say, I can't take it anymore. Amen. That's the God that we serve. God will fix them. And when God fixes your enemies, they are well fixed. I feel something pushing me. You see, when the divinity enters the realm of humanity, then the power of divinity must prevail. Talk to me, somebody. Oh God, I want to talk to God's people this morning before I put on the brakes. I don't know what you're going through. If you are in an emotional rut, if you are in a psychological rut, whatever that rut, that bondage, and that thing seems to have you in bondage and in captivity, I want to give you hope this morning that God is going to come through. He might not come when you want him, but he's going to be right on time. He's an on-time God. Yes, he is. Somebody praise God in the house. Hallelujah. And finally, Pharaoh's reluctance was only for a time. His reluctance in delivering the children of Israel was only for a time. Things changed at midnight. Somebody say midnight. Listen to the narrative of verses 31 to 32 of Exodus 12. And he called for Moses and Aaron by night. Somebody said, and said, rise up and get you from among my people, both ye and the children of Israel, and go serve the Lord. I love that. Right. The same man who said prior to that time, I will not let you go. And go wake them up out of their bed. I said, come. It's time to go. Somebody said, God of God. Every time, Sister Brown. Verse 32. Also he said, take your flocks. Somebody say blessings. Blessings. Somebody say blessings. Blessings. Take your flocks and your herds as he have said and be gone. And listen, bless me also. Yes. Uh-oh. Yes. Yes. Look here. Somebody say, God of God. And who God bless, no man curse. He who said, I will not let you go, was not telling them, I am letting you go. God will do it in a fine style. You see some people can't take you? You see, some people were tired to see your face. God is going to use them.
Lord Jesus,
them same one will have to come and they will have to say what they didn't want to say. Somebody say, what a God. It's only a matter of time. Tell me about time come. Let me haste now. I feel sweet in Jesus. Somebody say amen. I want to pause by saying, upon these verses, my brothers and sisters, it tells us four important truths about God. Number one, God's power supersedes all other power. What did I say? God's power supersedes all other power. His power, my brothers and sisters, is incomparable. There's no God like our God. He is the omnipotent God, the all-powerful God. Second truth, God will always prevail over the enemy. God will always prevail over the enemy. It is hard to kick against the brick. You can't fight against God and win. Somebody give God praise in the house. Hallelujah. Number three, God's enemy must bow to the might of his power. God's enemy must bow to the might of his power because God is in control. The fourth truth is that God's word will always prevail in the end. Can I say that again? God's word will always prevail in the end. He has the final say because he's the sovereign God. Amen. Somebody praise God in the house this morning. Stand with me all across this room and give God a praise in the house. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! God's power will always prevail in the end. By his sovereign will, he has the final say. Come on over here. Worship the mighty man of war. Lion of Judah. We bow down and we worship you. Somebody give God praise and glory in the house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God will pressure your enemy to breaking point. God will pressure your enemy to breaking point because God is the all-powerful God. And I remind you, my brothers and sisters, that Pharaoh's reluctance is no match to the power of God. His reluctance is only for a time. Hallelujah. Somebody worship the Lord. Mighty man of war, Lion of Judah, we bow down and worship you.
Lion of Judah. I don't know who, but today
pressure the enemy, Lord. Pressure the enemy.
And as we bring the curtains down, there's a power in the house. I'm going to be praying. Is there one who wants to say, Lord, I'm stepping out of my Egypt. I want this God who is greater than Pharaoh. I want to pray for you. Make your way down as I'm about to pray now for the others. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for your people this morning. Those that are held captive with all manner of bondage. Oh God Almighty, emotional bondage, psychological bondage, spiritual bondage. I command them now to be broken. Every spirit, oh God, of worry, every spirit of burden, every spirit of confusion, in the name of Jesus, I declare that they be gone in this hour. I speak healing, I speak deliverance, I speak restoration. For it's not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. I speak in somebody's midnight, in the name of Jesus. Enough is enough. Your people have cried long enough, carried the burdens long enough. Pressure the enemy to breaking point. We speak to the east, the west, the north, the south, and we say, give up! In the name of Jesus, we cover those watching us by the social media. We pray now that God, you will touch their hearts and their lives. You'll manifest your glory. You'll manifest your power and have your own way. Thank you for joining us this morning. And we say to you, continue to be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. God bless you as you continue to trust the true and living God. Amen and amen. We're going off here just now, but our moderator will return because we have to go through the lifting of the tithes and offering and gifts towards the work of the Lord. And then we will move into the announcement and right thereafter into our Sunday school. I want to say to you, continue to be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. God bless you. God bless you.